Hello, everybody, and welcome. My name's Alex Brasky, here to bring you another Section 5 football matchup on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel. Tonight's game features the Batavia Blue Devils taking on the Burgard Bulldogs of Section 6 at Vandetta Stadium right here in Batavia. The Blue Devils come into this one with a record of 2-0. Well, this is the opening game for the Bulldogs. They come in with a record of 0-0. First and foremost, we'd like to thank our sponsors for tonight's game. Beginning with Casella Waste, your number one provider for all your waste and recycling needs. Looking for residential pickup at your house, a dumpster or roll-off service for your place of business, call Casella Waste for the best rates and service around. Casella, always putting your waste to work. Call 585-308-0662 today for a quote. Ficarella's Pizzeria, get your fix at Fix. We have the only pizza pickup window in town, and we also deliver. Open today, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Visit Ficarella's at 21 Liberty Street in Batavia. Call 343-5545 to place your order or order online at ficarellaspizzabatavia.com. Also, Louie's in Attica. Stop on down to Louie's after the game and enjoy our wide variety of chicken wings, from our garlic parm to beef on wick wings. We have it all. Open today. Open Monday and Tuesday, 5 to close. Wednesday through Saturday, noon to close. Louis is here for you in Attica, turning friends into family since 1983. Also, Mugs and More, M&M's custom screen printing and embroidery has been providing quality, full-service screen printing, embroidery, and promotional products for your company, team, or personal needs for over 20 years. For more information on the products they offer, please visit Mugs and More's online store at www.mugsandmore.com or call Rob at 585-591-8803. Also, TF Brown's Restaurant in Batavia, 214 East Main Street, is the same location that housed the Mancuso family's first venture into the food business in 1930 and has been the home of TF Brown's for over 25 years. Whether you're looking for a great place for lunch or dinner, a place to relax and enjoy a beverage, or a place to hold any type of party or get-together, TF Brown's is ready to meet your needs and budget. Also, Mancuso Real Estate, proudly serving Batavia and Genesee County since 1911. Mancuso Real Estate is a full-service commercial and residential real estate brokerage firm. Call 345-1000 to let Rick Mancuso and Mike Sisson help you succeed. Georgian Suite Sales and Service is a full-service equipment dealership located in Pavilion, New York. Established in 1983, Georgian Suite has been providing exceptional sales, rentals, parts, and service in the Western New York area for over 35 years. Call or visit Georgian Suite at 7155 Brigtree Road in Pavilion or dial 585-584-3425, or you can log on to www.georgiansuite.com. Also, BlueDumpster.com. Are you in need of next-day service with reasonable rates? Contact BlueDumpster.com. Their roll-off dumpster business is family-owned, and they stand behind their service. Visit Blue Dumpster on their Facebook page or website, www.BlueDumpster.com, or call 585-768-7806.
Once again, good
with next-day service, convenient credit card billing, and upfront pricing, Blue Dumpster believes you'll be more than satisfied with what they offer. Visit www.bluedumpster.com today. Also, Bubba's Landscape in Leroy. Contact Bubba's for all your residential and commercial lawn treatment needs. You will spend less time on lawn care and more time doing things you love. Call now for an estimate, 585-768-6578. Also, Lathan Tree Service in Leroy. Since 1971, Lathan's mission has never changed to provide top-quality, value-based tree care service for our customers. Find out why thousands of customers have entrusted Lathan Tree Service by calling 585-766-2278 or finding them on the web at www.lathantree.com. And last, Empire Tractor, your local New Holland dealer, selling a full range of tractors and farm equipment. Empire Tractor is also proud to sell Dixie Chopper zero-turn mowers, the world's fastest mower, and are now selling and servicing the Coyote line of tractors, mowers, and utility vehicles. Check out their website at www.empiretractor.com or visit in person right in front of the Genesee County Fairgrounds on Route 5 in Batavia. Also, RA Heights Company Incorporated, owned by Richard Wendt, RA Heights is a family business established in 1945 at RA Heights. They specialize in residential and commercial roofing, metal roofing, gutters, siding, windows, copperwork, and sheet metal fabrication. Stay tuned. Near the end of the game, we'll be awarding the Casella Waste Athlete of the Game. Our early afternoon matchup, it was Ty Mott of Oakfield, Alabama, Elba, taking home Athlete of the Game honors. And Oakfield, Alabama, Elba defeated Canisteo Greenwood earlier today. And a few more scores from Thursday night. Avon, winners over Notre Dame. Livonia, winners over Dansville. Bath Haverling, winners over Wayland Cohocton. Leroy, winners over Wellsville. Attica, overtime winners over Letchworth Warsaw. And Medina in Section 6, winners over Newfane. Be sure to check out Inside High School Sports every Thursday at 7 p.m. on the Batavia Daily News Facebook page. This week, we feature the Oakfield, Alabama, Elba football team. Also, be sure to log on to thedailynewsonline.com as well as thelcn.com for all pregame and postgame coverage of Fall 2 high school sports. And as you see at the bottom of your screen throughout tonight's game, you'll see the Casella Waste scoreboard. A great sponsor of ours here at the Batavia Daily News is Casella as we get set for the national anthem.
Now may I ask if you'd all please rise and remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
All right, and just minutes away from kickoff here between Batavia and Burgard. This was a matchup that was scheduled at the 11th hour as Batavia's week three opponent, Geneva, was forced to forfeit. So this is going to be played as a no contest, but both teams still expected to be competitive here, especially Burgard, their first game of the season. So the Bulldogs looking to come out and get off on the right foot here this evening against a talented Batavia team that Captain has Ford begun the season with two Batavia straight wins. Therese Smith has helped lead the Blue Devils along with quarterback Jesse Reinhart.
Referee Pete McCabe, umpire Warren Brockman.
So we pause for a moment,
Danny Welch,
and we'll be back right near kickoff here from Vandetta Stadium.
John Driscoll. Burgard has won tonight's toss, but has opted to kick off to Batavia to start tonight's game. Thank you. Set to kick off for the Bulldogs, number one, Kyer Eaglin. Back deep for Batavia, number five, Therese Smith.
All right, here we go, getting ready for this one between the Bulldogs and the Blue Devils. Burgard won the toss, but they'll elect to kick it away to begin this game. Back deep to return the kickoff is Therese Smith for Batavia. The onside kick from the Bulldogs is recovered by the Blue Devils.
The onside kick recovered by the Blue Devils. They'll start first and 10 at the 43-yard line.
So first and 10 coming up for Batavia from their own 43-yard line. So as I said before, should be a good game between two talented teams, Burgard, an athletic bunch, according to Batavia head coach Brennan Briggs, a team that only won two games a season ago but returns plenty of starters from that squad, so expect good things from the Bulldogs here in their first contest of the season. Run from Therese Smith goes pretty much nowhere. A gain for four. He's able to fall forward. So a second and six coming up for Batavia. Snap, Reinhardt takes it, hands it off to Smith, breaks free, first down and more. Therese Smith down the sideline to about the 36-yard line. First and 10 coming up for the Blue Devils.
Again, it's 12 yards. It's first down Batavia at the Bulldog 36-yard line.
So Smith pushed out of bounds, and now Reinhardt will take the snap under center once again. Hands it off to Smith. A big hole, but he's wrapped up and brought down.
Smith on the carry, stopped by
a
Brandon
good stop
McNeil.
There from Brandon McNeil.
Give him 3 yards on the play. Second and seven at the 33-yard line.
Another run for the Blue Devils. Smith again inside the 25, inside the 20, and down at the 15-yard line. First and 10 once again for the Blue Devils. Therese Smith off and running in the early going here for the Blue Devils.
For Smith, first and 10, Batavia at the 15-yard line.
Reinhardt takes a snap, hands it to the up back.
Jaden Osborne.
Jaden Osborne falling forward for a small gain.
We're going to call it 6 yards, gain of six. Second and four at the 9-yard line.
Second and four coming up for Batavia. Hand off.
Therese Smith, the ball carry.
David down to the five.
Down to about the 5 yard line.
Smith.
Close to a first down.
Able to carry it forward for a first down. It's going to be first and goal from about the 5 yard line coming up for the Blue Devils. Reinhardt hands it off to Osborne, making his way toward the goal line, still on his feet. But but he's brought down at about the 2-yard line.
Jayden Osborne on the carry.
Second and goal coming up from the 2.
Second and goal from the 2.
Batavia from the 2, Smith off tackle and in to Rez Smith. Touchdown, Blue Devils. So with 8:30 to go here in the first quarter, to Rez Smith has put Batavia ahead. 6-0.
3-yard touchdown run for Batavia's Therese Smith.
Smith on the 2-point try, and he takes it through.
Smith in for the 2-point conversion.
For the 2-point conversion. 8-0 Batavia early in this one. We'd like to thank our sponsors, Casella Waste, Figueroa's Pizzeria, Louis in Attica, M&M Custom Screen Printing and Embroidery, TF Brown's Restaurant, Mancuso Real Estate, Georgian Swede Sales and Service, BlueDumpster.com, Bubba's Landscape, Lathan Tree Service, Empire Tractor, and R.A. Heights Company, Incorporated. Be sure to stay tuned near the end of the game when we award the Casella Waste
Bulldogs, 11,
player of the game.
Set to kick off for Therese Batavia,
Smith,
number 4, Tyler Busniak.
A step ahead of the competition in terms of the player of the game race as the early touchdown from Smith puts Batavia ahead. 6-0, and he also gets the 2-point try. So it's now 8-0 Batavia at the 8.5-minute mark of this first quarter. Burgard, a good return here and finding room across midfield. What a return there. Nazir Zinnerman.
On the return. Bulldogs will start 1st and 10 from the Batavia 45-yard line.
First and 10 for Burgard. Man in motion. Hand off to Zinnerman on the jet sweep. But a nice tackle made right near the line of scrimmage. Aiden Anderson on the stop for the Blue Devils.
44, Aiden Anderson. A gain of 1. 2nd and 9 from the 44.
Snap, motion once again. This time the handoff goes the other way. Brandon McNeil, he's brought down in the backfield. Matthew McQuethy in there on the stop for Batavia. It's now going to be a 3rd and 9.
It'll be 3rd and 10 for the Bulldogs.
Yeah. Bulldogs back to pass, looking to go deep, overthrown. Aiden Anderson there in the coverage. May have been a miscommunication there.
Intended for Kevon Walker. Fourth and 10 for Burgard.
Flag is thrown here. A legal substitution called on Burgard.
Ball moved to midfield at the 50-yard line.
It's going to set them back to a 4th and 15 now.
Myrie Harris set the punt for Burgard.
Excuse me. Burgard set to kick it away here. A high snap and a good punt. And Smith is chopped down. Failed to call for the fair catch, and it's all the way inside the five, but fielded by Batavia. Now the ball is out. Who's got it? The Bulldogs do. Fumbled away by Tyler Budziniak near the goal line, and now the Bulldogs are set up with great field position.
It'll be first and goal for Burgard at the 5-yard line.
First and goal coming up from the 5-yard line for Burgard. Both cheerleading squads on hand here today, Batavia and Burgard's. It's great to see the school spirit in full effect here at Vandetta Stadium. Hand off up the middle. Stop right at about the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up second and goal from the five. Once again, we'd like to thank our scoreboard sponsor, Casella Waste, for sponsoring tonight's broadcast and many of our broadcasts here on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel. Casella Waste, always putting your waste to work. So here's Burgard, second chance at the end zone, second and goal from the five. Under center, Kyer Eaglin. Turns around, fakes the handoff, rolling out now. Takes it himself, cross the goal line, and in for the Burgard touchdown. But a flag is down. We'll see what the call is. False start on the Bulldogs. So the touchdown is wiped off the board, and that's going to be a replay of second down, second and goal now from about the 10. I believe we have an illegal substitution again. I don't believe it was a false start.
The ball to the 10-yard line.
I think I heard correctly. Illegal substitution. That's another illegal substitution. So 5:42 to go in the first. Burgard with the touchdown, but it's wiped off the board due to the penalty. Sean Howard on the near side at wide receiver. Running back Brandon McNeil in the backfield, and another flag. Delay of game.
Another flag on the play.
No. We have a timeout called by Bulldogs.
But a timeout will be called by the Bulldogs.
All right, so out of the timeout, 5:42 remaining in this first quarter. Second and goal from the 10-yard line. Eaglin takes the snap, fakes the handoff, looking to throw into the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs, and flags come flying. We'll see who the call is on, but it's a touchdown to Kevon Walker.
Eaglin to Walker, 10-yard touchdown.
So the touchdown stands, the penalty, a personal foul called on the Blue Devils, likely for a late hit after Walker came down with that touchdown in the end zone, or maybe a high hit to the head area. So 5:36 to go here in the first quarter on a second down and goal from the 10. The Bulldogs put it in on the touchdown pass. 8-6 with the extra point upcoming. Eaglin directing traffic back there, and now the Bulldogs will go for two. Eaglin takes the snap out of the shotgun, met right in the backfield, and a nice stop there.
That's Eaglin on the two-point attempt, but it's no good, leaving the score Batavia 8, Burgard 6.
As it looked like a couple of big boys were in on the stop for Batavia, Abel Hammer among them. So with 5:36 to go, it's going to be 8-6. Batavia maintains its advantage.
Number 17, Myrie Harris, set the kickoff. Ball has been moved to the 45-yard line as a result of the personal foul penalty.
So Burgard takes the personal foul on the kickoff. And Batavia's going to have to work with some poor field position here, barring a miraculous return. And they won't get the opportunity as it's a touchback. Batavia's going to begin with the ball at their own 20-yard line. Be sure to stay tuned near the end of the game for the Casella Waste player of the game. Therese Smith with a leg up on the competition thus far.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line.
Davies' drive will begin from about the 20-yard line. Or at the 20-yard line, excuse me. Snap, handoff, Smith. Running to the near side, along the sideline, and across the 40-yard line. Therese Smith, another big gain up to the 44.
He'll get 24 yards pushed out of bounds by Brandon McNeil. First down, Batavia at the 44-yard line. Yeah.
So an illegal substitution on the Bulldogs, another one. Third of the game called on Burgard, their first matchup of the season. Burgard. So some early season jitters maybe being worked out by Burgard
here.
First and
five for the Blue Devils at the 49-yard line.
And Burgard is going to call a timeout here. So we're going to thank our sponsors. Beginning with Casella Waste, your number one provider for all your waste and recycling needs. Looking for residential pickup at your house, a dumpster, or roll-off service for your place of business? Call Casella Waste for the best rates and service around. Casella, always putting your waste to work. Call 585-308-0662 today for a quote. Also, Ficarella's Pizzeria, get your fix at Fix. We have the only pizza pickup window in town. And we also deliver open today, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Visit Ficarella's at 21 Liberty Street in Batavia. Call 343-5545 to place your order or order online at ficarellaspizzabatavia.com. Also, Louie's. Stop down to Louie's after the games and enjoy our wide variety of chicken wings. From their garlic parmesan to beef on wick wings, they have it all. Open Monday and Tuesday, 5 to close. Wednesday through Saturday, noon to close. Right in Attica, New York. Turning friends into family since 1983. So here's the snap from Batavia out of the timeout. Handoff goes to Smith. He takes it up the middle and across the first
Smith
down
up
marker,
the middle for the Blue Devils. Gets the ball to the 45-yard line, a gain of 6. It'll be first down for Batavia at the 45-yard line.
First set of downs coming up for the Blue Devils, who go quickly. Smith once again on the handoff, and he's pushed out of bounds.
Smith on the carry, knocked out of bounds. One of the tacklers, number 14, Jason Rivera.
It's going to bring up second and 15.
A loss of 6 yards and moves the ball back into Batavia territory. Second and 16.
I'd also like to thank Mugs and More. M&M Custom Screen Printing and Embroidery has been providing quality, full-service screen printing, embroidery, and promotional products for your company, team, or personal needs for over 20 years. For more information on the products they offer, please visit Mugs and More's online store at www.mugsandmore.com or call Rob at 585-591-8803. Reinhardt drops back, looking to throw, has a man near the sideline, but beyond his reach, looking for Alex Hale there. We'd also like to thank TF Browns in Batavia. 214 East Main Street is the same location that housed the Mancuso family's first venture into the food business in 1930 and has been the home of TF Browns for over 25 years. Whether you're looking for a great place for lunch or dinner, a place to relax and enjoy a beverage, or a place to hold any type of party or get-together, TF Browns is ready to meet your needs and budget. Also, Mancuso Real Estate, proudly serving Batavia and Genesee County since 1911. Mancuso Real Estate is a full-service commercial and residential real estate brokerage firm. Call 345-1000 to let Rick Mancuso and Mike Sisson help you succeed. Reinhardt back to pass again, has a man wide open near the sideline, and it's dropped. Also, George and Swede Sales and Service. Whether you need excavators, wheel loaders, trailers, rollers, or skid steers, George and Swede has the equipment you need, including Hyundai construction equipment. George and Swede has been a dealer of Hyundai construction equipment since 1994, selling and servicing Hyundai machines longer than anyone in the state. So a nifty formation here for the Blue Devils as Reinhardt shifts out to wide receiver. It's a 4th and 16 as I'm too caught up with the advertisements here. But for good reason. These advertisements and our sponsors do a great job sponsoring high school sports throughout the GLOW region as a bobbling return there from the Bulldogs, able to get it under control.
The
Bulldogs will begin their possession
here. First and 10 for the Bulldogs at their own 34-yard line.
Also, BlueDumpster.com. Are you in need of next-day service with reasonable rates? Contact BlueDumpster.com. Their roll-off dumpster business is family-owned, and they stand behind their service. Visit Blue Dumpster on their Facebook page or website, www.BlueDumpster.com, or call 585-768-7806. With next-day service, convenient credit card billing, and upfront pricing, Blue Dumpster believes You'll be more than satisfied with what they offer. Visit www.bluedumpster.com today. So here's Burgard back out for another drive. After the Batavia punt, it's first and 10 for the Bulldogs. 4:54 remaining in this first quarter. Under pressure is Eaglin. He's able to escape and work his way for a minimal gain. We call it a one-yard gain, so that's going to bring up second and 9 for the Bulldogs. Also, we'd like to thank Bubba's Landscape in Leroy. Contact Bubba's for all your residential and commercial lawn treatment needs. You will spend less time on lawn care and more time doing things you love. Call now for an estimate, 585-768-6578. Also, Lathan Tree Service. Since 1971, Lathan's mission has never changed, and that's to provide top-quality, value-based tree care for their customers. Find out why thousands of customers have entrusted Lathan Tree Service by calling 585-768-2278 or finding them on the web at lathantree.com. So here's the Bulldogs, second and 9. Eaglin tosses it out into the flat, connects with Nazir Zinnerman, who works his way up near the 40-yard line. That's going to bring up a third and about 5.
He'll gain 4 on the play, puts the ball at the 39-yard line. Third and 5 for Burgard.
Also, Empire Tractor, your local New Holland dealer, selling a full range of tractors and farm equipment. Empire Tractor is also proud to sell Dixie Chopper zero-turn mowers, the world's fastest mower, and are now selling and servicing the Coyote line of tractors, mowers, and utility vehicles. Check out their website at empiretractor.com or visit in person right in front of the Genesee County Fairgrounds on Route 5 in Batavia. So the 3rd and 5 from the Bulldogs. Eaglin back to pass, has a man, and it's picked off on the deflection. Batavia is going to take over on the interception. Caden Marucci, great hand-eye concentration, able to reel that one in. And the Blue Devils are going to take over near midfield.
And Batavia will start first and 10 from the Burgard 46-yard line.
Also, R.A. Heights Company Incorporated, owned by Richard Wendt. R.A. Heights is a family business established in 1945. At R.A. Heights, they specialize in residential and commercial roofing, metal roofing, siding, windows, copperwork, and sheet metal fabrication. So here's the first snap of the drive for the Blue Devils. A little miscommunication in the backfield, but Reinhardt takes it up the middle for a burst. And across the 25, but a flag behind the play.
He brings the ball down to the 25-yard line. A 22-yard gain for Reinhardt.
So a 22-yard gain, likely going to be wiped out due to a Batavia penalty.
A penalty
personal
flag
foul
on the play.
Called on Batavia.
And a holding call called against Batavia.
Maybe it was holding. Sorry, a long way up here. So as I reset the down and distance, it's now going to be a first and 20 for the Blue Devils.
Penalty moves the ball back to the 44-yard line. First and 19 for Batavia.
Reinhardt tosses it out to Hale, who breaks through for a nice gain up near the 40-yard line. Alex Hale makes it. A manageable second down here. Second and about 4
moves the ball
coming
back
up
into Bulldog territory at the 41-yard line. Gain of 15 yards. Second and 4 for Batavia.
As you see on the bottom of your screen, the Casella Way scoreboard. It's Batavia with a second and 4. Reinhardt under center. Hands it off to the up man, Osborne. Falling forward,
Jayden,
it's going to bring up a 3rd and 1.
Stopped by Urice Patrick. A gain of 3 yards. 3rd and 1 from the 38. Try Rez Smith on the carry, gain of 4 yards, but it will be a Batavia first down, first and 10 from the 34-yard line.
For the Blue Devils. Reinhardt flips it out. Caught. Wrestled
pass
down to the ground.
Pass
was complete
play.
To Bannon Moore. And that's going to be a loss on
Reinhardt
the player.
To Bannon Moore, number 20.
And a dead ball personal foul on the Bulldogs.
And a personal foul called against Burgard.
That's going to move Batavia up and give them a
ball
first down.
Ball will be moved to the 20-yard line. First and 10 for your Blue Devils.
Ball at the 20-yard line now. Ball's on the ground, and another whistle, and flags come flying.
Penalty flag on the play. Penalty against the Bulldogs. 5 yards. First and 5 for Batavia at the 15-yard line.
Reinhardt out of the pistol, turns around, hands it off. Smith with a stiff arm, works his way to the sideline, and he's pushed out of bounds.
Brad Smith pushed out of bounds by 13.
For no gain.
Kevin Staley.
Or maybe a loss of one, so that's going to bring up second
loss
and six.
Loss of one on the play. Second and six from the 16-yard line.
Reinhardt takes a snap, feeds it to Smith. He's brought down after a short gain. That's going to bring up third and manageable. Third and three coming up for the Blue Devils.
From the 14-yard line.
I forgot to start the clock. My apologies. We're inside 20 seconds to go here in the first quarter. And it looks like Batavia is just going to wind the clock out. And that's going to do it for the first quarter of play. So we take a quick break here from Vandetta Stadium in Batavia. Batavia leads 8-6.
That is. A timeout was called by Burgard with 2 seconds left in the first quarter.
All right, a lot of confusion here, but I think it's going to be the end of the first quarter when it's all said and done.
And that is the end of the first quarter. With the score, Batavia 8, Burgard 6.
So 8-6 at the end of the first quarter. It'll be third and three coming up for the Blue Devils to begin this second. Be right back after a short break. All right, so here we are to begin the second quarter. Third and three coming up for the Blue Devils, nearing the end zone. Snap, Reinhardt looking to throw. Has a man near the pylon, and he's undercut as he was leaping for the ball.
Reinhardt's pass incomplete.
And it falls incomplete.
It'll bring a fourth down and four.
Fourth and three coming up for the Blue Devils. Fourth and three, the Blue Devils will go for it. Snap. Smith. Steps out of a tackle. Another one and across the goal line. Terrence Smith is second. Touchdown of the game. Start for Terrence Smith as he takes the handoff on the two-point try, and he's stacked up before the end zone. So
and the two-point conversion is
he will not get across the goal line there, but he's already across the goal line twice as Batavia takes a 14-6 lead over Burgard to begin the second quarter. Reminder, we will be awarding the Casella Waste Player of the Game at game's end or near game's end. Looks like Terrence Smith on his way to those honors here this evening. Batavia, 14-6 over Burgard, 11:47 remaining in the second. Here's the kick fielded by Deshaun Howard. And he's spun down, a nice tackle there.
Deshaun Howard on the return.
Made by Tyler Budzniak.
Tackle made by the kicker, Tyler Budzniak. First and 10 for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 coming up for Burgard, 11:39 remaining in this second quarter. Eaglin takes the snap, turns around, hands it off, but met in the backfield is Brandon McNeil. He's brought down for a short loss, going to bring up a second and 12 now.
Loss of two on the play, second and 12 from the 21-yard line.
Thank you.
Brandon McNeil on the carry.
McNeil chopped down once again.
A gain of 2 yards on the play. It'll be third and nine from the 24.
Third and nine coming up for the Bulldogs. Under duress, Eaglin able to get away and make the throw downfield. Alex Hale, nice coverage provided in the Blue Devils' secondary.
Eaglin's pass attempt to Ross, incomplete. Coverage by
Aferio Ross, the intended target.
Fourth down, fourth and nine for Burgard.
But it falls incomplete. So a fourth and nine coming up now.
Number 17, Myrie Harris, set the punt for Burgard.
Burgard will punt it away. Excuse me, my microphone got caught up beneath my jacket here. Happened a few times tonight, so if you hear muffled audio, that's the reason. Delay game called on Burgard.
Moves the ball back to the 19-yard line.
Make it fourth and longer. Fourth and 14 now for the Bulldogs, excuse me. Snap. Kick is away near midfield. Comes down near a Blue Devil. But Hale able to get away from it. And it comes to rest at about the 43, where
ball down by
Batavia's
going to
begin their drive.
Sean Howard. First and 10 for Batavia at their own 4-yard line.
Here we go to begin the Blue Devils' drive. 9:52 on the clock in the second quarter. Reverse handed to Aiden Anderson across midfield.
Number 44, Aiden Anderson.
Looked
on
like
the
Deshaun
carry.
Howard was going for the strip there, but couldn't quite get it as Anderson was able to hold on. It's going to bring him a second and about four.
A gain of 7 yards. Second and three from the Burgard 49-yard line.
And in motion is Anderson, and another flag.
Illegal procedure.
False start on the Blue Devils. That's going to make it a second and nine now for Batavia.
It'll be second and eight from the 46-yard line.
Anderson in motion. Handoff to Smith up the middle. Finds a crease. Terez Smith drops the ball. It's still loose. Howard in there diving after it, but I think Batavia came up with it, and they did.
By Terez Smith, but recovered
Anderson,
by Batavia.
Johnny on the spot, able to come up with the fumble. It's a first and
ball
10 as Smith took
Batavia
it for a big gain and then started to kick the ball around before Anderson was able to fall on it. Whistle will stop the clock. A timeout
called by the Blue Devils.
Batavia.
It's their first of this first half. Two timeouts remaining for each team. 8:29 remaining in this first half. It's a 8-point Batavia lead. So a few notes from around the league, a few big performances this weekend. Leroy Knights 55-0 winners yesterday. They've now outscored their opponents 94-0 through 3 weeks. The Knights just rolling in Class C, waiting for an end of season clash between the Knights and the Bulldogs of Livonia, both unbeaten in Class C. The Bulldogs, the defending Class B champion where Batavia resides, but the Bulldogs dropped down to Class C this season. So they'll be competing with the likes of Leroy and other Class C opponents for their sectional title. That should leave Class B wide open with Batavia in contention and really leading the way, as they've been mighty impressive in the early going. Therese Smith has been one of the top players in Class B out of the backfield for Batavia. And you've seen it once again here tonight already with a couple of touchdowns. Jesse Reinhardt has yet to get going, but he's also capable of throwing the ball for scores for Batavia. Smith off the edge, breaking free, but he's tripped up across the 30-yard line.
Stop by number two, Brandon McNeil, number 10.
McNeil on the stop.
Jason Knox.
And also Jason Knox.
Second and six from the 28.
Second and six coming up now. Batavia closing in on the red zone. The flip to Anderson on the jet sweep. He stood up. A nice tackle there by Deshaun Howard. He's had
Dean
a nice
Anderson
day defensively for Burgard.
Tackle made by Deshaun Howard.
It's going to bring up third down.
Gain of one on the play.
In about five. My apologies on the down and distance there, but it's now third and five for the Bulldogs. Snap, Reinhardt looking to throw, dropping back, has a man, and he connects with him. Alex Hale in stride. Touchdown, Batavia.
Touchdown, Batavia. Jesse Reinhardt to number one, Alex Hale.
I told you Reinhardt can toss it, and he displays it there, finds Alex Hale perfectly in stride for the Blue Devils touchdown. Six Blue Devils in the lead, 7:11 to go here in the second. And the Blue Devils will go for two. Reinhardt takes the snap, overthrows Anderson in the end zone.
Keeping the score, Batavia 20.
So it remains a 14-point game, Batavia in the lead.
Kickoff recovered by number 16, Rashawn McNeil.
So Burgard begins their drive after the Batavia touchdown. Reinhardt to Hale. Beautiful throw.
47.
From Reinhardt, found Alex Hale in stride, able to get open into the secondary. And it's now a first and 10 for the Bulldogs near midfield. Burgard drive begins. Snap to Eaglin, going deep, has a man wide open, and he connects. Leferio Ross inside the 30 and down to the 27-yard line. A big play for the Bulldogs, excuse me, on their first play of the drive.
Eaglin to Ross, first and 10 for the Bulldogs at the Batavia 28-yard line. Number 5, Desir Zitterman on the carry. Brings the ball to the 24-yard line. 4-yard gain. 2nd and 6 for Burgard.
And a beautiful defensive play by the Blue Devils.
Eaglin is sacked behind the line of scrimmage by number 13, Peyton Marucci.
Peyton Marucci, another big defensive play for Batavia. As he gets in there for the sack.
A loss of 11 on the play. The ball spotted at the 35-yard line. 3rd and 17 for the Bulldogs.
Bulldogs seem to be gaining a little bit of momentum there before Batavia pours cold water on it with the sack from Marucci. Back to pass, Eaglin looking deep and coming over for the pick. Tyler Budzniak, interception. Batavia going the other way and flags come flying.
Tyler Budzniak on the interception for Batavia, but penalty flags on the play.
What a play from Budzniak, and Batavia in business now. 5:14 to go in the first half. We'll see what the flags are. I believe you'll see it come on the Bulldogs, but we'll see.
Call is a block in the back on the return against the Blue Devils.
So no, it's on the Blue Devils on the return, though, so the interception will stand.
It'll be 1st and 10 for Batavia.
Nice play from Budzniak going over to pick that one off. So it's going to be 1st and 10 for Batavia, 5:14 to go here in the first half. And another flag comes in. Illegal substitution on the Blue Devils. It's about the 8th illegal substitution that we've had today.
5-yard penalty against Batavia. 1st and 15 from the 4-yard line.
1st and 15 now coming up for Batavia. Reinhardt takes a snap. Ball is out in the end zone. Did he get him in the end zone?
And he fumbled.
It's a safety. The Bulldogs.
And 2 points awarded to Burgard.
Get 2 points back on the tackle in the end zone. Batavia, I think, is calling for the incomplete pass. We're going to have a discussion here, but the call in the meantime is a safety. And it's an incomplete pass. So 2 points taken off the
and
board.
Now they call it an
incompletion.
Pass.
As I didn't get a good look on that, I was looking at the camera viewfinder at the time.
So
we'll have to try to catch that one on the replay to see exactly what happened, but ruled an incompletion. And it's going to be second and 15 with 5:14 on the clock.
Jaden Osborne on the carry. He gets 2 yards. Third and 13 from the 6 yard line.
Hand off up the middle. Smith,
Smith
down
on the carry.
So approaching 4.5 minutes
gets
to go
the ball
here.
Up to about the 12-yard line. A gain of 6.
And my apologies on the
fourth
down
and
distance.
Eight.
Fourth and 8 now.
For Batavia.
Snap. Punt was tipped, I believe, and it doesn't go very far. Out of bounds at about the 25-yard line.
Punt lands out of bounds at about the 25-yard line.
First and 10 coming up for the Bulldogs. So the safety wiped off the board, but now the Bulldogs with prime field position. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half.
First and 10 Bulldogs at the Batavia 25-yard line.
Here's a Burgard player is being carted off the field on the opposite side. We're going to try to see who that is, but I don't believe he has his jersey on anymore. We wish the best for that young man. Hopefully it's not too bad. Obviously bad enough he's got to be carted off, but Eaglin forcing his way ahead, about a gain of 5. Clock will keep rolling. We're about at 3:40 to go. It's going to be about a second and 5.
Second and 5 from the 20.
A long day here. We've been taking in two games this afternoon and this evening. Oakfield, Alabama, Elba with a win earlier, and now Batavia leading Burgard. A reverse and room to run. Lefario Ross inside the 10 across the goal line. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
That's number 3, Lefario Ross on the reverse.
A timely call there from the Bulldogs coaching staff on the reverse to give Burgard the touchdown. And now they'll look for the to cut it to 14 with the 2-point conversion. Or excuse me, cut it to 6. I'm sorry. They're looking to score 14. My apologies. Getting a little confused here. As I said before, been a little bit of a long day, so just bear with me. Out of the shotgun, takes the snap. Eaglin not able to find the goal line. And
the 2-point conversion, no good.
It's going to remain a 8-point game, 20-12. We got ourselves a good one here between Batavia and Burgard. We'll take a quick break before the ensuing kickoff.
Larry Harris set the kickoff.
All right, we're getting ready to go. The ensuing kickoff following the Bulldogs' second touchdown of this game. So we got a ball game here. 8-point game inside, 3 minutes to go in the first half. Bulldogs kick it away. Smith unable to field it cleanly, but picks it up off the turf and now retreats, trying to get away from tacklers, but eventually he's corralled at about the 10-yard line.
Smith on return brings the ball out to about the 10-yard line.
So now we're at 2:50 remaining in this first half. First and 10 coming up for the Blue Devils. Yeah, we do have a Burgard player, and he's pointing to his back as if to say that's the reason why I'm being carted off here. So as we said before, we hope the best. Hope for the best for that young man. Yes, what a surprise. Another flag on the field, but it's waved off. So the snap by the Blue Devils, a nice burst ahead by Smith, nearing a first down. That's going to bring up a second and about two.
Second and two for Batavia.
Getting a little chilly up here, up top at Vandetta Stadium. I'd like to thank the Batavia administration for setting us up inside a heated press box upstairs here. As Smith is into the secondary, and here he goes, the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, the 5, pylon. Out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. Smith, what a run.
Smith on the carry for Batavia, knocked out at the 4-yard line. That's a 78-yard gain for Smith. First and goal for Batavia.
Therese Smith putting on a show here at Vandetta Stadium. And you know, each game you really try your best. Excuse me, as I was looking down my phone, got a little bit sidetracked. So a gain of two there, second and goal now from the 2-yard line. Snap, Smith, handoff, stretching for the goal line. Ball's out, who's got it? Burgard believes they do. And they do, the Bulldogs recover the fumble, 1:44 to go in this first half, and what a turn of events. Smith, the 70-plus yard gain, and now a turnover. And Burgard's gonna take over, looking to go the length of the field. Under 2 minutes to play in this quarter.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs at their own 4-yard line.
Not that tall. So Smith, not happy with that fumble, very disappointed in himself as he was looking for another touchdown. But instead, here come the Bulldogs running it.
It'll be
looking to wind the clock, perhaps.
From the four.
Looking to just get into halftime with this light deficit of 8 points. I think you'll take that as a win if you're the Bulldogs. So could have been worse, especially with that last drive from Batavia with the long gainer from Smith. 1:15 to go now in the first half. Toss. McNeil on the run. Good gain across the 10 to about the 13.
Brings the ball out to the
nearing a first down. It's now going to be a third and about
one. Just shy of a first down. Third and one for Burgard. Fans at halftime, make sure you visit the Pub Hub coffee truck out in the parking lot. All proceeds tonight benefit the Batavia High ski team. So grab a cup of coffee on a nice cool night. Thank you very much.
So 20 seconds remaining in this first half. Burgard just working down the final seconds here. The handoff to McNeil puts his shoulder down, and that is just about going
to
do it. But that's a first down, so the clock will stop momentarily.
First down for Burgard.
And here we go. The clock will wind, and that's going to do it for the first half. Batavia with a 20-12 lead over Burgard. We'll be back after a short break.
And that is the end of the first half of play with the score, Batavia 20, Burgard 12.
All right, we're getting ready to go here in the second half. Batavia with a 20-12 lead over Burgard.
Judgment called by officials, coaches, and themselves are made in good faith and should be respected. Spectators can support both of these teams by refraining from derogatory or demeaning comments and cheer today. We hope that you'll enjoy the game and support the students in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. More awesome tunes are coming up here on Game Time.
More awesome music
all the time
here in Batavia.
So it was an exciting first half. Batavia began the game red hot, but Burgard continued to battle. And it's now just a one possession game at the break, so expecting a good second half. Although this is being played as a no contest, it hasn't stopped both teams from putting it all out there and really giving it full effort here tonight. Therese Smith, a huge first half for Batavia. Also, Jesse Reinhart connected with Alex Hale for a touchdown. Caden Marucci has had a big first two quarters on defense for the Blue Devils. While Burgard has been led by their quarterback, Kyer Eaglin, and LaFerio Ross, who scored the last Bulldogs touchdown. So looking forward to an exciting second half right here on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel. 2 minutes to go until the opening kickoff. Before we get to the opening kickoff of the second half, of course, we'd like to thank our sponsors, beginning with Casella Waste, your number one provider for all your waste and recycling needs. Also, Ficarella's Pizza, get your fix at Fix. We have the only pizza pickup window in town, and we also deliver. Louie's in Attica, stop on down to Louie's after the game and enjoy our wide variety of chicken wings, from our garlic parmesan to beef on weck wings. We have it all, open Monday and Tuesday, 5 to close, Wednesday through Saturday, noon to close, right here in Attica. Turning friends into family since 1983. Mugs and More, M&M custom screen printing and embroidery, has been providing quality full service screen printing, embroidery, and promotional products for your company, team, or personal needs for over 20 years. For more information on the products they offer, please visit Mugs and More's online store at www.mugsandmore.com or call Rob at 585-591-88. TF Brown's Restaurant, 214 East Main Street in Batavia, is the same location that housed the Mancuso family's first venture into the food business in 1930 and has been the home of TF Brown's for over 25 years. Whether you're looking for a great place for lunch or dinner, a place to relax and enjoy a beverage, or a place to hold any type of party or get-together, TF Brown's is ready to meet your needs and budget. Also, Mancuso Real Estate, proudly serving Batavia and Genesee County since 1911, Mancuso Real Estate is a full-service commercial and residential real estate brokerage firm. Call 345-1000 to let Rick Mancuso and Mike Sisson help you succeed. Georgian Swede Sales and Service, a full-service equipment dealership located in Pavilion, New York, established in 1983. Georgian Swede has been providing exceptional sales, rentals, parts, and service in the Western New York area for over 35 years. Call or visit George and Swede at 7155 Big Tree Road in Pavilion, 585-584-3425. So here we go. We got a couple more sponsors to get to, but the start of this second half from Vandetta Stadium. The kickoff goes to Burgard, and the ball is loose. Batavia falls on it and recovers the onside kick.
By the Blue Devils. First and 10, Batavia at the Burgard 47.
So Batavia, huge start to this third quarter, and they take over first and 10 inside Bulldogs territory. Snap to Reinhart, turns around, hands it off. Here comes Smith bursting through the middle. Smith Brought down near the 30-yard line. First down for Batavia.
15-yard gain for Therese Smith. First and 10.
We'd also like to thank BlueDumpster.com. Are you in need of next-day service with reasonable rates? Contact BlueDumpster.com. Their roll-off dumpster business is family-owned, and they stand behind their service. Visit Blue Dumpster on their Facebook page or website, BlueDumpster.com. First and 10 for the Blue Devils. 11:30 to go here in the third. Hand off to Smith up the middle. He's brought down near the line of scrimmage. And a couple more sponsors to get to. Bubba's Landscape and Leroy. Contact Bubba's for all your residential and commercial lawn treatment needs. You will spend less time on lawn care and more time doing things you love. Call now for an estimate, 585-768-6578. Also, Lathan Tree Service in Leroy. Since 1971, Lathan's mission has never changed, and that's to provide top quality, value-based tree care to our customers. That's Lathan's Tree Service in Leroy. My apologies, a little late on the trigger there, but the handoff to Smith. He's up across the 25-yard line and brought down. It's going to be a third and three coming up for Batavia. Just have to get to a couple more sponsors here. Empire Tractor, your local New Holland dealer, selling a full range of tractors and farm equipment. Empire Tractor is also proud to sell Dixie Chopper zero-turn mowers, the world's fastest mower. So handoff from Reinhardt, and the ball's out. Batavia fumbles it. The Bulldogs recover, and we're going the other way. Burgard football
at about the
Bulldogs' 25-yard line. A huge turnover by Batavia as they were nearing the end zone once again. And last but not least, RA Heights Company Incorporated, owned by Richard Wendt. RA Heights is a family business established in 1945. At RA Heights, they specialize in residential and commercial roofing, metal roofing, gutter, siding, windows, copperwork, and sheet metal fabrication. So all set with our sponsors there. You see the Casella scoreboard has returned. And the Bulldogs are set to begin their drive at about the 27 yard lines. Low snap on the ground, and a flag is thrown. A shocker there. We've had plenty of those
flag on the play
here tonight.
And it's a procedure penalty called against Burgard. 5-yard penalty.
That's going to bring up a first and 15 now.
From the 20-yard line.
As the Bulldogs are set back on the penalty. Snap, going deep is Eaglin. He's got his man. Ross across midfield. A nice throw and catch for the Bulldogs. About 30 yards on that throw and catch, and Ross is slow to get up at the end. So Ross was able to get up after that. Seems to be okay. Why? Because I got so many clothes on? It's cold out. The window's open. And my ball, or my chops busted over here by Matt Holman. Figures. I'm dressed up like an Eskimo, he says. I got the window wide open here. It is a heated press box. But I run cold. I tell people all the time it was 60 degrees the other day, and I was still cold. So Ross was slow to get up, and I'm just noticing this now. There is a Burgard player down well behind the play, and that's the reason for this delay here. So my apologies on the late information here. I was updating social media with the updates from the first half, but it does appear as if a Burgard player is down near the 15-yard line on the left side of your screen. And there is a trainer out there tending to him. We're unsure who the player is, but wish the best for that young man and his return to the field after this injury. We'll take a quick break here from Vandetta Stadium. Looks like the injured player, unfortunately, is Burgard quarterback Kyer Eaglin. As he was very slow to get up, and it doesn't appear as if he's able to move very quickly off the field. So very small steps being taken by Eaglin to get off the field. Does not look good for him, but like I said before, we hope for the best for his health. So the Burgard Bulldogs are going to have to move forward without their starting quarterback now in a highly competitive game here, 20-12 against Batavia. We'll see who comes in at quarterback for the Bulldogs. A quick reminder, we will award the athlete of the game near the end of this one. And that's brought to you by Casella Waste, also sponsoring our scoreboard. Snap, handoff. Brandon McNeil coughs it up. He's able to regain. And Batavia brings him down. Terez Smith on the tackle. A big loss for the Bulldogs as McNeil coughed it up, regained, and ran backwards. And now the Bulldogs in dire straits. A second and very, very long coming up for Burgard.
It'll be second 23 for the Bulldogs. Number three, Lefario Ross, now at quarterback for Burgard.
Fumbled around by Ross, the new quarterback for Burgard, and
Ross
he's brought down for another loss. So my apologies. It's now third and very long. Third and about
a loss of 7 yards.
30.
Third and 30 from the 32.
Burgard loses its quarterback and now loses plenty of yards, and they're set back deep behind the original line of scrimmage. Ross takes the snap, trying to find room, but he's wrapped
Ross
up
on the carry.
around his legs. A nice tackle there once again. Terez Smith, he's had himself a nice two-way game tonight.
For the Bulldogs.
So Smith really having his way with this Burgard team here tonight. He's been mighty impressive on both sides of the ball. Fourth and a mile coming up for the Bulldogs. We're approaching 8 minutes to go in this third quarter.
Myrie Harris set to punt for the Bulldogs. Back deep for Batavia, number five, Therese Smith.
Smith back to receive the kick. And the Bulldogs get it away, but it takes a Batavia bounce back toward midfield before Deshaun Howard chases it down to down it.
At the 47-yard line.
So first and 10 coming up for the Blue Devils. 7:41
from their own
remaining in this third quarter. The cart coming out for Kyer Eaglin. Unfortunate news there for that young man. Had a good game tonight. Helped keep Burgard in the game here as it's only an 8-point Batavia lead with 7:41 to go in the third. We'll see if the Bulldogs can regroup here on defense and hopefully carry some momentum over to the offensive side of the ball with a new quarterback. Whistle before the snap and a timeout, as I forgot to reset the timeouts at half. So a timeout called by Burgard. It's their first of this half. So 7:40 remaining in this third quarter. Batavia looking to increase its lead. We take a quick break here at Vandetta Stadium. Back to action here. 7:40. Reinhardt takes the snap, dropping back, looking to throw, has his man. A diving catch made by Evan Cummings, but no. It hit the turf. That's going to be ruled incomplete. Going to bring up second and 10 for the Blue Devils.
Evan Cummings incomplete. It'll be second and 10 for the Blue Devils.
Here's Batavia. Reinhardt takes the snap, hands it to Smith, but he's met in the backfield. A nice defensive play there from Jason Rivera.
Rez Smith caught behind the line of scrimmage by number 14, Jason Rivera. A loss of 4 yards.
It's going to bring up third and long, third and about 14, coming up for the Blue Devils.
Third and 14 from the 43-yard line.
Reinhardt evading pressure, a nice job evading the rush. Able to get away from McNeil, throwing on the run, and it's batted down. Looked like Jason Knox was over there on the defense.
That'll bring a fourth down.
In coverage, I should say. So it's going to bring up fourth and long. Looks like Batavia's going to come out to punt. I was just going to message somebody, and now I forget. That's what happens when you're doing a million things at once. All right, so here we go. Batavia will punt. 6:46 on the clock. A snap causes Budzniak to go back, and he loses the ball. Ball on the turf. Burgard scoops it up. And the Bulldogs set up with beautiful field position. Looked like it was Kevon Walker, excuse me if I'm pronouncing that incorrectly, on the recovery.
It'll be first down for Burgard at the 13-yard line.
First and 10 coming up for the Bulldogs, looking to tie the game here with a touchdown and a two-point. So disaster for Batavia as they turn it over on the punt. Ross will call for a timeout, and that will leave it at 6:36. Timeout on the field.
Timeout.
Called by Burgard. We'll take a quick break, and we'll filter through our sponsors. I know we missed a couple on the last time around. I believe we ended with George and Swede. So we'll take you back there quickly, and then we'll take you through the rest a little bit slowly. So here's George and Swede, and we'll move forward. Quick reminders, if I haven't reminded you enough already, the athlete of the game brought to you by Casella Waste coming up near the end of this one. Therese Smith seems to be the runaway candidate, but you never know what will happen from here to the end of the game. Each player of the game this season will be presented a $25 gift card to TF Browns in Batavia. So here we go, the Bulldogs knocking on the door inside the red zone, first and 10 with 6:36 to go in the third. Ross back to pass, under duress, being chased, but he's able to get it away. Avoids the sack.
Ross
it's going to bring up just a second and 10. Could have been much
Howard
worse
complete.
There for the Bulldogs. So a nice second job of eating the sack by Ross. Here we go, second and 10 coming up for the Bulldogs, looking to cut it to two or perhaps tie the game here. Ross out of the shotgun, sends a man in motion. It's Myrie Harris who lays a good block on the edge, which allows Ross to break free, and he's inside the five, out of bounds at about the 2 yard line.
Should be
a first down and goal from about the two.
Bulldogs at their own, excuse me, at the Batavia 2 yard line.
And a flag flies, likely for delay of game here on the Bulldogs, and that is what the call is. It's a delay of game, too much time used up by the Bulldogs. So that's going to set them back. It was a first and goal from the two. It's now going to be a first and goal from the seven. So that might change the play call here for Burgard. Snap, flag comes flying in, and the play is whistled dead.
Penalty flag once again on the play. Procedure
call start, a procedure call on the Bulldogs. So a first and goal from the two is now a first and goal from the 12.
It's now first and goal from the 12.
Plenty of mistakes from Burgard, but that's to be expected. It's their first game of the season. Quick ramp up after the basketball season, so Bulldogs working out the kinks here in a no contest. No harm, no foul. But they'll want to get these cleaned up for next week, that's for sure. So Ross out of the shotgun, takes the snap, looking to throw, rolling out, looking for a man. He finds him, and it's a touchdown. Bulldogs into the end zone. Ross finds Zinnerman for the score.
Mario Ross to number five, Nasir Zinnerman. 20-18.
2-point game.
Batavia.
The Bulldogs will look to tie it with the 2-point. Handoff pushing their way toward the goal line. Bulldogs, are they in? No. They come up short. It remains a 2-point Batavia lead. 6:10 to go here in the third quarter. So a few scores from around Section 5 football action. This weekend, we had Oakfield, Alabama elbow roll. Canisteo Greenwood in our first game tonight. Also some scores from Thursday night, Avon over Notre Dame. Livonia beat Dansville. Bath Haverling over Wayland Cohocton. Leroy still unbeaten with a win over Wellsville. Attica defeats Letchworth Warsaw in overtime. And Medina defeated Newfane. We'd like to remind you to tune in to Inside High School Sports every Thursday at 7 p.m. on the Batavia Daily News Facebook page. This week we feature the Oakfield, Alabama Elba football team. Here we go, 6:10 remaining. The kickoff coming up from the Bulldogs as they cut it to a 2-point Batavia lead. So a rolling kick sent to the middle of the field, but Batavia able to fall on it.
Fielded by Batavia, Jaden Osborne.
Osborne fields it and falls on it. So first and 10 coming up for the Blue Devils. 6:10 remaining in the third. Oh, and we had Cal Mum defeated Clyde Savannah today, as I see in my text here a little bit. Buried. I was unable to see that earlier. Cal Mum defeated Clyde 35-20. Jacob Capitelli, two touchdown runs. Alex Carnes, a 35-yard touchdown pass from Kyle Wade. And Evan Ranowitz with a pick six for the Raiders. Ranowitz had two near interceptions last week against Notre Dame. Went right through his hands. So it's good to see him come away with one this afternoon and take it the distance for the touchdown. So second and 11 now coming up for Batavia, as I forgot to start the clock. We'll get that updated here inside 6:40 or 5:40 to go in this third quarter as Reinhardt takes the snap, rolling out, evading pressure from Kevin Walker, and it falls incomplete. Pass was intended for Alex Hale.
Third and 11 from the 47-yard line.
Third and 11 now coming up for Batavia. Reinhardt drops back, going deep, has a man! But a beautiful pass breakup, Rashad Abdelief. What a play. As Abdelief was there on the coverage to knock it away.
It's now fourth and 11.
Looked like Reinhardt had Budzniak down the field. That's going to bring up a fourth and 11. Batavia's going to have to punt it now. Ross fields the punt.
Punt return by LaFerio Ross to the 35-yard line. First and 10 for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 coming up for the Bulldogs. 5:18 remaining in this third quarter. Been a great game here for a no contest, especially. This game not going to affect the records for either team, but impressive effort from both sides, to say the least. This has been played exactly like a real game would be expected to be played. The officials have done a great job keeping everybody involved, not letting things get sloppy here. I'm sure that that was one of their focuses coming into the game. I think that's why you've seen so many substitution penalties and ticky-tack fouls, because I think that the officials that coming into this game, you know it's going to be a no contest. You know the competitiveness might be lost, and you really want to set the tone early that this isn't going to be a sloppy game. We're going to have to be on our P's and Q's. We're going to have to make the right reads, the right substitutions. And a good job by the officials setting the tone of this game here tonight. And it's been a good one. This has been one of our best games that we've had on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel this fall two season. Plenty of blowouts. But last week between Notre Dame and Kale Mum, and this game, really our two best games of the year, as the clock winds underneath 5 minutes to play in the third. Snap, Ross flips it forward, and he has a man complete. Excuse me for the shoddy camera work there, and that's going to be a first down for the Bulldogs.
Ross's pass is complete out to the 45-yard line. It'll be
fresh
a first
set of
down
downs
for
now.
Burgard at their own 45.
For Burgard, 4:20 remaining in this third quarter. Ross takes the snap. Option play, Brandon McNeil on the flip. And he falls ahead for a short gain. Good job making something out of nothing there. And that brings up a second and 7.
Brandon McNeil on the carry. He gains 2 yards. Second and 8 at the 47.
Ross takes the snap, hands it off on the jet sweep. Deshaun Howard takes it, nearing midfield, but he's wrestled down. A nice play there from Aiden Anderson, excuse me.
Number 11, Deshaun Howard on the carry. No gain.
No gain on the play. It's going to bring
third
up second
seven.
And 7. Or excuse me, third and 7. They're inside 3 minutes to go in the third. Ross takes the snap, looking to throw, directing his man to go long, and he throws an interception right to Reinhardt, right in the breadbasket. Reinhardt picks it off.
But a penalty flag on the play.
But a penalty flag on the play. We'll see who the call is on here. Holding on the Bulldogs, so the interception
will
stand. First and 10 coming up for Batavia. The interception from Reinhardt, and just like that, he's throwing his hat into the ring for player of the game. A touchdown throwing, and now the interception on defense. Reinhardt having himself a day here.
Make that the 46-yard line. First and 10 for Batavia.
Thank you. Reinhardt takes the snap and flags come in. I believe we're going to see offside on the Blue Devils.
Procedure penalty against Batavia, 5 yards.
That is what we see.
First and 15.
False start called on Batavia. Snap, handoff, Smith finding room on the edge, breaking free across the 40, across the 30, inside the 20, the 10, the 5. Therese Smith walks into the end zone. Blue Devils add to their lead here in the third.
59-yard touchdown run for your Batavia Blue Devils.
So the two-point try is successful for the Blue Devils, and with 2:06 to go in the third, Batavia's lead is now at 10, 28-18. So here we go after the latest Batavia touchdown run for Therese Smith. As he's exhausted down on the field. It's a fantastic effort from Therese here tonight. Both sides of the ball, like I said before, making tackles, running for touchdowns. Great effort from Therese Smith. Likely our player of the game, but you'll have to stay tuned for that. And an unfortunate sight here, as it looks like, yes, an ambulance has come onto the field on the Burgard sideline. Non-emergency, obviously, but an ambulance has come onto the field. I'm not sure who for, but not a great sight to see at any sporting event. So a 28-18 lead for the Blue Devils. The kick is away. And Ross on the return. Across the 30, near the 40, and breaking free across midfield. Ball is out. Who's got it?
Ferio Ross on the return. He fumbles on the return. A penalty flag is down as well.
A penalty flag is down.
And it looks like Burgard has recovered the fumble, but let's see what the penalty is.
Burgard did recover. We'll see what the penalty turns out to be here. Personal foul, block below the waist.
Shot block called against Burgard.
On Burgard. Great job by the officials signaling here in this game. Did not see that in the game prior and really have struggled with that all season on our broadcast, but head official Pete McCabe doing a great job signaling to us line. Up here in the booth, letting us know what's going on. Much appreciated
for the Bulldogs
to Pete McCabe. So a first down and 10 coming up for the Bulldogs from their own 15-yard line. 1:55 to go in the third. Batavia leads by 10. As Batavia Athletic Director Mike Bromley doesn't let me slide on anything. It appears I left the flag icon up during the latest Therese Smith touchdown, so my apologies for that. But I think I've been pretty good with the scoreboard here tonight, working the camera, the play-by-play, and the scoreboard alone. So, you know what? Get off my back. Long time athletic director here, Mike Bromley. Does a great job getting us set up here atop Vandetta Stadium. So appreciated in that regard, but not appreciated the hard time he's given me over the flag icon. Ross tripped up from behind.
And Ross dropped from behind the line of scrimmage as well. A loss of four.
It's going to be a loss second and 19 coming up. Listen to those Burgard cheerleaders. They've been into it all night long, providing their team with some great school spirit. Kudos to them. Ross in the end zone, evading tacklers, able to work his way back out of the end zone and for a short
Ross
gain.
Ross on the carry. He'll gain about 3 yards on the play.
My apologies for not resetting.
It'll be second and 16
here, as I say that I'm doing a
from
good
the
job.
9 yard line.
Poor job. So third and 16 now, inside a minute to go. Here in the third. Pass is complete. And the Bulldogs get themselves the first down.
Ross's pass is complete to number five, the Sears Zinnerman.
Zinnerman,
the ball
out the catch.
The 30-yard line. And it'll be first and 10 for the Bulldogs.
And with that, the third quarter going to come to a close.
Quarter.
We head to the fourth. It's a 10
with
point.
The score, Batavia 28,
Batavia advantage.
18.
Once again, we tell you about our sponsors here, beginning with Casella Waste, your number one service provider for all your waste and recycling needs. Looking for residential pickup at your house, a dumpster, or roll-off service for your place of business, call Casella Waste today. Ficarella's, get your fix at Fix. We have the only pizza pickup window in town, and we also deliver. Open today, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Louie's in Attica. Stop on down to Louie's after the games to enjoy their wide variety of chicken wings. From their garlic parmesan to beef on wick wings, we have it all. Open Monday and Tuesday, 5 to close. Wednesday through Saturday, noon to close. Right here in Attica, New York, turning friends into family since 1983. Mugs and More, M&M Custom Screen Printing and Embroidery has been providing quality, full-service screen printing and embroidery products for your company, team, or personal needs for over 20 years. Also, TF Brown's Restaurant in Batavia. Whether you're looking for a great place for lunch or dinner, a place to relax and enjoy a beverage, or planning any type of party or get-together, TF Brown's is ready to meet your needs and budget. Also, Mancuso Real Estate, proudly serving Batavia and Genesee County since 1911. Georgian Suite Sales and Service in Pavilion, a full-service equipment dealership, now selling Hyundai construction equipment. They've been doing so since 1994, becoming the longest seller and servicer of Hyundai machines in the state. BlueDumpster.com, are you in need of next-day service with reasonable rates? Contact BlueDumpster.com. Bubba's Landscape. Contact Bubba's for all your residential and commercial lawn care needs. Empire Tractor in Batavia and RA Heights Company Incorporated. So here we go. The snap for Burgard. The pitch over to McNeil, and he's brought down after a short gain. Going to bring up second and 8.
McNeil on the carry. He'll gain 2 yards. Second and 8 from the 32-yard line.
Second and 7:30 to go now here in the fourth. Ross takes the snap, dropping back, looking to throw. Can't find a man, gets it away, and good thing he did as Abel Hammer was there on the pressure. What a name. What a football name, Abel Hammer. Trying to lay the hammer there on Ross, but able to get it away for the incompletion. It's going to bring up third and eight now.
Third and eight for Burgard.
Ross back to pass, evading pressure. Gets it away, has his man, Jason Knox, on the completion. Ball comes out.
Pass complete.
Who's got it? Batavia's got it.
Jason Knox, but the fumble recovery made
another fumble. And Batavia comes up with it. 11:02 to go here in the fourth. Batavia set to take back over. Already leading by 10.
33-yard line.
Once again, we'd like to remind you, we will award the athlete of the game near the end of this one. Likely going to be Terez Smith, but also Jesse Reinhardt in the running. We'll see how this one turns out. Stay tuned for the player of the game. Cal Mum and Oakfield, Alabama Elba picked up wins already today. Here are the scores from last night's Section 5 football action. Here we go. Just about a minute gone in this fourth quarter. Reinhardt takes the snap, turns around, hands it to Smith, trying to get the edge, and a flag behind the play as Smith's able to work his way ahead for a first down. See what the flag is here. Holding on the Blue Devils, so that's going to be a major setback for Batavia. Going to bring up probably a first and 20 now for Batavia.
The ball brought back to the 44-yard line. It'll be first and 21 for Batavia.
Reinhardt takes a snap, back to pass. Had a man a little bit high, and Evan Cummings couldn't come up with it.
Reinhardt's pass incomplete. Second and 21 for Batavia.
Reinhardt back to pass, going deep, has a man, Buzniak, but he overthrew him.
Pass intended for Tyler Buzniak, incomplete. Third down for Batavia.
Third and 20 now coming up for the Blue Devils. Reinhardt had him there. Could have brought him back into the player of the game race, but he overthrew Buzniak. Reinhardt back to pass once again, going deep, this time over the middle, his Buzniak again, and he makes a leaping catch.
And that pass is complete. Reinhardt to Buzniak.
Tyler Buzniak, what a grab from Reinhardt. And the Blue Devils are set up inside the 5-yard line. 39-yard strike from Reinhardt to Buzniak.
First and goal from the 5. 5-yard line.
So just like that, Jesse Reinhardt, a big pass to Buzniak, and now Batavia knocking on the door, 10:20 to go. Reinhardt hands it off to Smith. Smith finds his way into the end zone to finish off a fine drive for the Blue Devils. Another Batavia touchdown, 34-18, Blue Devils blowing out the Bulldogs. Remains here. The Blue Devils, another touchdown, 34-18. They'll look to go for two here to extend their lead to 18 points and double up the Bulldogs. Reinhardt, corner of the end zone, lobs it up. Incomplete. It will remain
a 16-point game. Good. Leaving the score, Batavia 34 and Burgard 18. Fans, Batavia's next home game will be on Wednesday, April 14th, as Midlakes comes into town. Game start time, 7 p.m. on Wednesday the 14th. Batavia's next home game here at Vandetta against Midlakes.
And that game will also be broadcast here on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel. Batavia versus Midlakes next week on Wednesday. So be sure to check back for programming information and a stream link to be posted to our social media in the coming days. It's been a successful high school sports season for us here at the Batavia Daily News. I have to thank our sponsors for that. I have to thank you, the viewer, also the athletes and coaches for putting on the show that gets you to tune in each night. It's just been an exciting return to the field, the court, the ice, and what have you. And Batavia sure as heck happy to be back on the football field as they lead 34-18 over Burgard here. You see the Casella Waste scoreboard up there. Casella always putting your waste to work. So the kick fielded at about the 25. Burgard works his way up to about the 35.
Returned by Deshaun Howard.
And Howard is dropped right at the 35-yard line.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 coming up here as the Bulldogs look to cut into this 16-point deficit. Only a two-possession game, so the Bulldogs still within striking distance. And Batavia will look to keep them off the board here. Fakes the jet sweep. Ross keeps it himself, and he drops the ball. Fumble. Who got it? Looks like Ross came up with it, so Burgard will keep the ball, but another fumble on this cold night at Vandetta Stadium. Second and long coming up for the Bulldogs. It's going to be a second and 13. Excuse me, make that 23.
Loss of 13 yards on the play. It'll be second and 23 from the 22.
So a whistle here and a flag is out. Delay of game on the Bulldogs. So that's going to set them back even further to a second and 28.
Delay of game penalty will move the ball to the 17-yard line. Second and 28 for the Burgard Bulldogs.
Back to passes. Ross throwing off his back foot. And that's picked off. Reinhardt on the return. Reinhardt inside the 10. Reinhardt into the end zone for the touchdown. Excuse the camera work. The flag is out. And an injured Bulldog is down on the field. We'll sort this one out and see if the touchdown on the pick six from Reinhardt will stand.
Personal foul against Batavia.
And it's a personal foul on the Blue Devils. That will wipe away the touchdown as the Bulldog is down on the field injured. It's number 53, Larrell Jamison, but he's up and at him, so it appears he's going to be okay. But a personal foul called on Batavia. That's going to give Burgard a first down here. And boy, are they lucky, or fortunate, I should say, as Reinhardt took that one the distance. That would have made my job much more difficult for the player of the game.
Roughing the passer penalty moves the ball to the 37-yard line. And first and 10 for Burgard.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. 8:53 to go in the fourth. It's only a two-possession game here, so the Bulldogs well within striking distance. Man in motion was Myrie Harris, but flags come flying, and that's going to be an offside penalty on the Bulldogs. So after the penalty on Batavia, it's now going to be a first and 15 after the error by
First and 15 for Burgard.
Snap, Ross takes it, looking to throw, flips it ahead, and it's knocked down. Good coverage there, provided
number 17, Harris, incomplete.
But it looked like Caden Marucci.
Defender. Second and 15 from the 32.
Second and 15 now, 8:48 to go. Time winding down. What's been a long day here at Vandetta Stadium. Ross takes the snap, looking to run. Tip from behind, ball is out, but it's ruled incomplete. As it looked like Knox was looking to advance it, but the officials rule it incomplete.
From the 32-yard line.
It's going to bring up third and 15 now. Snap to Ross, a high snap, flips it over and incomplete.
Ross's pass attempt to Jason Rivera, incomplete. Fourth and 15 for the Bulldogs.
Fourth and 15 coming up for Burgard, and they're going to have a decision to make here. Trailing by 16, time winding down in the fourth. Will they go for it on fourth and long? Burgard elects to punt, and the punter fans on it.
It will be Batavia ball, first and 10 from the 22-yard line.
So Batavia takes over. Final 8:33, seemingly nothing but a formality here as the Blue Devils in great position to add on to their lead. Reinhardt takes the snap, hands it to Smith, trying to find the edge. He does inside the 10. Another touchdown for Therese Smith. And that's the dagger. I believe as it's now 40-18. Blue Devils in the lead just inside. 8 minutes to play.
40, Burgard 18. Attempt
kick
is good.
Up and it is good.
41-18,
Batavia in the lead now. See what happens in the final 7:58, but it seems as if Therese Smith is locked up player of the game honors here in this one. He's just been explosive from the opening kickoff on both sides of the ball, but particularly offensively, where he has, I believe, 4 touchdowns, or perhaps 5 touchdowns, I'm not sure. Lost count, he scored so many dang times. Kick is away, and it gets past Deshaun Howard, but he's able to track it down and work his way forward past the 20-yard line to the 24.
Brings the ball out to the 24-yard line. Bulldogs will start first and 10. 7:45 left in the fourth quarter.
Handoff, not much there for McNeil.
Number 2, Brandon McNeil on the carry. He lost it 2 yards. Second and 12 at the 21.
Two, second and 12 now for the Bulldogs. Ross takes the snap, looking to throw, evading pressure, gets it away, incomplete, tipped, and almost caught by a Batavia defender. Looked like Cummings was in there.
Ross's
no,
pass to 15, Kevon Walker, incomplete.
It's in Grazio playing in there. Burgard. On the breakup, almost came away with the interception, it looked like. So pass falls incomplete. That stops the clock with 6:24 remaining here. Third and 13, third and 12 coming up for the Bulldogs. Ross takes a snap, dropping back, spinning to evade pressure. Able to get away near the sideline and now breaking free up the sideline near midfield. Runs out of bounds at about the 41.
Mario Ross on the quarterback keeper. Pushed out of bounds at the 41-yard line, a gain of 20 yards. First and 10 for Burgard.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs here. Snap. Ross flips it over to McNeil, finds room to the outside, across midfield, across the 45, and out of bounds at about the 42-yard line.
McNeil bringing the ball inside the territory.
First down for the Bulldogs.
Brings it to the 41-yard line, gain of 18 yards. First and 10.
Tickling my throat.
For the Bulldogs.
So how about a shout out to the cheerleaders out here tonight, the Batavia cheerleaders. Frigid night here at Vandetta Stadium, but the cheerleaders are out in full force. And on the other side, the Burgard cheerleaders doing a great job providing some school spirit for their squad here tonight. Ross takes the snap, hands it to Zinnerman. Zinnerman finding some room along the outside, another first down for the Bulldogs before he's pushed out.
He's pushed out of bounds after a 16-yard gain. First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Ross takes a snap, flips it out. Caught by Jason Rivera, but brought under tackle immediately. I'll tell you what, Ross has looked good playing quarterback ever since. Unfortunately, Eaglin left the game due to injury. Bulldogs offense really hasn't missed a beat with him taking the snaps.
2 yard gain, second and 8 from the 22.
2 yard gain is now a second and 8 coming up for the Bulldogs. Time winding down here in the fourth, approaching 3 minutes to go. And after this snap, we will award our Casella player of the game. So be sure to stay tuned for that in just a few moments here. There's a man in motion for the Bulldogs. Ross back to pass, stiff arming away. Throwing near the goal line, and it's caught into the end zone for the touchdown. Zinnerman.
Complete from Ross.
And the Bulldogs continue to battle here. It's now a 41-24 lead for Batavia. And we'll wait until the extra point here to award the player of the game. But what a throw and catch. Ross to Zinnerman for the touchdown. Bulldogs not going down without a fight here. Ross takes the snap, looking for a man into the end zone behind his man, and the two-point try is no good. So our athlete of the game for this one, Therese Smith of Batavia. I believe 4 or 5 touchdowns here this evening. A nice game on defense. So Therese Smith will get a $25 gift card to TF Browns in Batavia, courtesy of Casella Waste. So Therese Smith, your player of the game here tonight. So Batavia will get the ball back. First and 10 coming up after the kickoff. 2:36 remaining in the fourth quarter. I believe you'll just see Batavia really wind the clock out, not looking to have any injury or anything happen in the final moments here in a no contest that they're going to be the winners on the scoreboard, but already earned the win with a forfeit from Geneva. And now Batavia looking to go 2-for-1 as they've put forth a fine performance here tonight. Burgard boots it away. Reinhardt recovers. And Batavia is going to begin the final drive of the game with about 2.5 minutes remaining. So we're inside 2 minutes now as the clock is winding. Just looking to get out of here. This is the cold night at Vandetta Stadium. Be sure to tune in for our stream schedule to be released for next week, coming up in the next couple of days. I know that we have the Batavia versus Mid-Lakes game, so tune in for that. I believe we also have Livonia visiting Attica. So those are some upcoming games that we have for you here on the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel as there's a minute and a half remaining. Therese Smith, your Casella Waste player of the game here tonight, and a wire-to-wire victory for the Blue Devils. They are 3-0 with a forfeit from Geneva, but a nice performance here tonight against Burgard. So a timeout on the field with 1 minute to go. And the clock starts with 1:02 to go. Batavia with a running play, and we're going to go inside a minute remaining. Ball came out, I think, but I believe it's going to stay with the Blue Devils.
Ball marked at the 45-yard line. 3rd and 5 from the 45.
So 24 seconds on the clock. Batavia takes a knee, and the Blue Devils win. Well, it's a no contest here, so I guess they don't win. I don't know what you call this. A win, sort of, for the Blue Devils. A great performance here tonight. My name's Alex Brasky for the Batavia Daily News YouTube channel, signing off here from Vandetta Stadium. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you
coming to Batavia this evening.
Next time.